Need tools? We've got you covered. Go to ChromebookParts.com or click on the link below to pick up this sleek, portable toolkit. Place the device on the heating pad and heat it up to about 168 degrees Fahrenheit. Leave it on there for about 10 to 15 minutes until it's very warm to the touch. Gently insert the opener tool underneath the digitizer and carefully slide it along the edges to pry it free from the adhesive underneath. Be sure not to use the tool on the side with the volume buttons, as this is where the cables for the digitizer and home buttons are located. Also, you're going to want to keep your tool very shallow when you're working away around the home button, so as to avoid severing any of the nearby cables. Try to avoid using too much force when prying the digitizer up, as you don't want to crack the digitizer. Also, don't go in too deep as you risk scratching the LCD. Take your time, and if necessary, reheat the device to loosen the adhesive. Once you've freed three sides of the digitizer, lift it part ways up and lean it up against something. Do not lay it all the way down. Remove four 3.5 mm screws from the LCD panel. Keep in mind that two of these screws are covered up by tape. Lift the LCD panel partway up and also lean it against another object. Remove three 1 mm screws from the LCD connector bracket. Gently lift up to unplug the LCD panel, and you are now free to remove it. Gently lift up to unplug the digitizer cables. Peel back the tape, remove the foam covering, flip open the locking clip, and unplug the home button. Gently peel the digitizer free from the rest of the adhesive. Using a plastic tool as shown, gently pry the battery free from the adhesive underneath. If needed, you can use a small amount of 99% isopropyl alcohol solution in order to help dissolve the adhesive. Take your time and carefully work your way around the battery. Once you've loosened the battery, remove this 1 2-millimeter screw. Carefully insert your spudger underneath the bracket, slowly pry it up, and lift the battery free from the post to remove it. Using the 99% isopropyl alcohol solution, carefully remove all the excess adhesive from around the edges and in the middle. Once all the adhesive has been removed, use the spudger again to pry the bracket up and create enough space so that you can slip the battery underneath and back onto the post. Just be careful not to pry too hard. Replace the 1 2-millimeter screw. Peel the coverings from around the sides of the new digitizer. And set the digitizer into place leaned up against an object. Plug the home button cable back in. And plug the digitizer cables back in. reapply the tape, and replace the foam. Set the LCD into place like so, leaned up against an object. Plug the LCD back in. Replace the LCD connector bracket. And replace the 3 1-millimeter screws. Gently lay the LCD panel back into place. And peel the coverings off the adhesive along the sides. Replace the 4 3.5-millimeter screws back into the LCD panel. Before laying the digitizer down, peel the plastic covering off from underneath. And make sure to clean any dust or particles off the LCD panel. Once you're sure it's clean, lay the digitizer down into place and push down around the edges to secure it to the adhesive. Finally, remove the plastic covering from the top of the digitizer.